My camera turns on, but it won't take any pictures or video or playback video. Here you can see I've retrofitted my bolas. This originally was one bolas with six balls on it. I turned that into two bolas with three balls each. So this way I'm carrying around the same amount of weight, but I'm actually getting two shots instead of just one. The gauchos in Argentina have their bolas where one string is significantly shorter than the other two strings. And so that way it can actually just like intertwine something really good. So hopefully with this new setup, I'm gonna have better luck getting at a turkey. I spotted a turkey. See him? Damn it. Turkeys, they give me a slip again. The vendetta continues. Since I have destroyed two cameras this week, we're gonna go shopping.
Yay!
I have acquired many things. Consumer day. We're ready to seriously start documenting. What do you think, consuming?
I want to consume
it. Does it feel good? So here we have my backpacking stove. It runs off kerosene or gasoline or white gas or anything. So I thought that maybe I could run it off the heads from my persimmon brandy. Whoa. This doesn't quite look right.
Boil water at least.
You could probably, could you boil?
Uh oh, it's overflowing. Uh oh. I'm gonna go ahead and say that we can't run my backpacking stove off of the heads for my distilling project, unfortunately.
I'm in Santa Barbara visiting Al, and I figured maybe I'd attempt to spearfish again. So hopefully I don't explode my knee and I just come back with a lot of fish.
Even though running my backpacking stove with my distillate didn't work, I decided to break into my gasoline stash because I'm in Santa Barbara and it's much easier to cook on the camp stove than to make a fire in Allison's backyard. We have heard from one of our connections that there is an awesome fig tree on State Street, so we're looking for it. It's coming up here. Supposedly there is very large green figs on this fig tree. Alright, I'm gonna hop out. This appears to be the tree. Alright, I'm really confused. Because this looks like a fig, but it's not a fig at all. I'm officially gonna say that we got denied on this one. This is some kind of weird ornamental fig that just doesn't look like it's gonna get ripe. Does anyone else out there know, is this edible? Most people know what a kiwi is.
I just wasted a lot of calories looking for fish and I saw none.
We have found another mysterious fruit. This is called a chirimoya. Very strange subtropical fruit. So we're gonna pick some of these and see if they ripen up.
was down in Louisiana, just about a mile. Here is the sampling of some of the food I'm going to eat today. We have 20 mussels here, strawberry guavas, and then we also have the palm fruit. And you'll recognize these zapotes from my earlier video. I found three little zapote trees that were growing. And so with any luck, maybe I can get these to grow in Big Sur or in my greenhouse.
This week has really affirmed my suspicions that this right here, a mussel bar, is much more useful than either a spear gun or a fishing pole or a fishing reel. For very little energy, you can get a whole lot of food, and you're pretty much guaranteed to get it as long as you know where some mussels are. I've been in Santa Barbara all week, and I've only managed to procure mussels. They're pretty awesome because they lock down their shells, and since they're, you know, upper tide dwellers, they pretty much will just stay closed and stay fresh for who knows how long. I mean, I save these for 4 or 5 days, and they don't seem to lose any freshness. So they're really perfect for the post-apocalyptic consumer, such as myself. We're gonna go fishing again. Do you think we're gonna catch anything, Allison?
Yes, I do.
How sure of this are you?
I'm 100% sure. About a mile from Texarkana, in them old cotton fields back home. In them
old cotton fields back home. Another benefit to eating mussels is pearls, of which I found two in my little bowl of mussels this morning.